good drive, and Barnes doesn't want to let it go to waste.
San Francisco trying to come back here in the first quarter. Plenty of time.
All right. Hey.
There's a secret society where the night is eternal. The music is essential, and the party is nonstop. You could be the newest member. The MGD Music Jet Tour. Four parties, four cities. One unforgettable trip. Peel the label, enter the code at MGD.com, and prepare for takeoff.
Tom Green here at Muscle Beach with some big, tough weightlifters.
We're going to show how light guard extreme sport works even under the most extreme conditions.
Back, stop! Uh-oh. Run! Oh, no, the kid's going to get you! He got you! Look, extreme protection against odor and wetness. Goes on clear and it doesn't quit.
Right guard extreme sport. Get extreme. Get right guard.
Ouch.
Pain, sacrifice, risk, all for a shot at $1 million.
The best team in the XFL, guys.
They won four straight.
I don't think nobody's gonna stop us right now.
One team stands between them and the $1 million game.
Division champs, baby!
The Western Division champion Extreme continue to light up the scoreboard and have $1 million dreams of their own. The Enforcers, the Extreme, the XFL playoffs, Sunday on UPN. The past, an epic playoff battle that went the distance. The present, a final regular season encounter. And as the playoffs loom large, will a rematch be in their future? The Blazers take on the Lakers to cap an NBA triple header on NBC.
San Francisco Demons in the midst of their finest drive of the night, one that's already consumed six plays and 68 yards. In fact, this drive has had San Francisco run more plays than Orlando has run all night.
Come here.
But look at the scoreboard.
35 Dallas. Gunner. Boom. 35 Dallas. Dallas.
Some confusion on the play call. Guy got in there and really applied some pressure to Barnes, and Pat's lucky just to get it away as he had Andre Purvis coming up in his dish.
All right. Okay, I hear you. Relax.
Dallas, backside 28. There we go. Doubles left. 35 Dallas, backside 28. 35 on one. Ready? 35. Money. Go. 319.
San Francisco shows the same set now on third down. Calvin Anderson in the backfield with Barnes. More time. Got a man wide open. Overthrown Travis Moore. Oh, my goodness.
There was the play to get him back in the football game. Moore wide open over the middle, and Barnes just hung it out too long.
First series of the game, he had Jimmy Cunningham and wide open on that pump fake, and then threw that one a little bit off his back foot. Sure touchdown.
So here's Mike Panasek now, the former drama teacher from Lebanon, Indiana, who took a leave of absence to kick field goals in the XFL. A 42-yarder by Panasek is good to put the Demons on the scoreboard at the Citrus Bowl tonight.
Now, courtesy of Busch Beer, let's take a look at how the Orlando Rage got here. The Rage clinched the East title with a win over the New York Hitmen. Brian Shea took back the opening kick 95 yards to set up an easy touchdown.
Look at Brian Shea go!
Brian Kuklick, making his first start for the Rage, threw a TD to Diallo Burks to put Orlando at 7-1.
We got us 7-1. We got two more to go. Two more right now, that's right. Then we got two more to go.
Hell yeah!
Four games left.
One hot.
Yes.
We might have a smash.
San Francisco able to get on the scoreboard.
All right.
After a nice drive, they failed to convert the touchdown, but those points, that's an important psychological lift after going behind 16 zips.
Well, there's also another negative for Orlando. When you get things, and Mike can tell you this, when they come too easy, too quick, you can get a tendency to back off a little bit, lose your intensity. You think you got it made.
Orlando been the beneficiary of bad field, a good field position. Also, the turnovers at San Francisco self-inflicted.
This game's far from over.
Ryan Shang, a former Emporia State standout, to begin this kick return at his goal line. Dropped around the 22-yard line. That's where the Ravens take over with 2:36 left in the first quarter.
Tell the back not to be offset if he can help it.
1-800-01, right?
Michael Black is the back that's rotated in for Orlando. In the self-policing unit, here comes Eric Englund. Look out. Before he's ripped out of bounds, he gets it off to Mario Bailey. Super Mario Brothers still on his feet before John Haskins can drop with a 43, a gain of 20 for Orlando.
Brian Kukla keeping this play alive. His rollout here, thought maybe about throwing the ball away, but saw Mario Bailey instead, and this guy can do a lot of things in the open field with the football tucked underneath his arm. What was a sack turns into a 20-yard gain for Orlando.
Hey, just tape it up.
On the ground, and there is a flag on the play. Michael Black, the ball carrier, dropped by Toby Wright.
Holding.
And indeed, holding on Orlando.
Where are we here? Take. You're going to take the 10-yard. Previous spot. Holding. Number 73, offense. 10-yard penalty, repeat, first down.
Penalties really got in the way of Orlando's attempt to win their ninth of the season last week. Penalties, couple of drops, couple of turnovers, not the kind of stuff that happened against the Rage all season long. They played very clean football.
Liz. Trademark of Galen Hall teams.
Go!
That penalty, the first on the Rage tonight. Here's Kuklick to throw. He's got a completion to Diallo Burks.
Good job, Diallo!
A gain of 11 for Orlando. They get some of that back.
Good job, baby.
San Francisco defensive line facing a similar problem to the one they faced last week when Tommy Maddox from Los Angeles, the short three-step drops. Brian doing much the same thing here. Michael Black,
couple of guys miss him. Three guys miss him. Got to wrap him up.
Oh, man, just bad tackling right there.
Greg Williams. The Demons' free safety had him all wrapped up and couldn't make the tackle.
There you go, Boop. Get it. Foul call!
Oh, that's just a lot of guys just grasping for straws and trying to tackle his head. It's a gain of 12, and they move the chains of first down for Orlando.
Also, a lot of arm tackling. You got to go through the man. You can't stop one of these backs with your arms today.
Final seconds ticking down on the first quarter. We won that the Rage. There's Diallo Burks again. End of quarter, and it was a good one.
NBC Monday, all you watch.
We got fire.
A production so huge, it brought New York to a standstill.
The whole damn thing's coming down.
We don't give up!
A third watch spectacle with the New York Giants' Jason Sehorn.
Come on!
This one could take everything they've got. Third Watch Inferno, all new NBC Monday.
Hold it!
21, please.
Like playing around with stuff? Spy, you can play around with anything you want. Actually, that's half the fun. Best Buy, go ahead, turn on the fun.
I have discovered Euphorium. The entire supply seems located right where I'm standing. California, find yourself here.
Even though we just turned 60, we're still climbing mountains, trekking through forests, and playing in the mud. And now we're celebrating that heritage during the Jeep Anniversary Event. Get a $1,000 cash allowance and 0.9% APR financing when you buy a Grand Cherokee. Or returning Daimler Chrysler lessees with preferred credit can lease one for just $369 a month. So come celebrate our great past. It'll make for an exciting future. Check one out at your Jeep dealer.
I'm 9 News medical reporter Dr. Stephanie Clements, and as a health professional, I know early detection can save lives. That's why the 9 Health Fair is just what the doctor ordered. The 9 Health Fair offers basic screenings for free, plus a long list of supplemental low-cost tests. The 9 Health Fair, keeping Colorado healthy.
Quest Diagnostics, proud partner of the 9 Health Fair, providing quality laboratory services for 22 years.
An exceptional Easter forecast. We'll have it at 10.
You're watching the XFL on NBC.
A fresh 15-minute clock here for the start of the second quarter. It starts with a hand of Brian Shea. He's wrapped up for a loss on the play. Craig Powell in on the tacklers for San Francisco. First quarter dominated by Orlando in rather unusual fashion. Two San Francisco turnovers certainly play a big part as Orlando got their 16 points
at
on only
zero,
five plays.
0-24 Y under on one, right?
And not only that, but bad special teams play on the kickoffs. They started twice inside their 10.
Play action pass here on third and one. San Francisco brings the blitz, gets picked up nicely. Craig Powell gets to him, however.
That's why you never give up on a play right there. Powell went down, got back to his feet, and still made a big sack.
A loss of 10 on third down and a big stop for San Francisco. And because Powell was coming all the way, never got a chance to get action mode. Give credit to the Brian Shea for picking him up momentarily, but Kuklik never had a chance to get that ball off. XFL's leading punter is on to kick it away. It's a live ball at the 18-yard line. Jimmy the Jet Cunningham returned one punt for a score against New York earlier during the regular season. This one bounces out of the end zone. Monday night on NBC, don't miss the premiere of Weakest Link, the game that's faster than Millionaire, more suspenseful than Survivor. Weakest Link premieres Monday at 8, 7 Central on NBC. I love that lady. You are the weakest.
Who got me? I had time if you had done that.
Mike could be on that show, The Missing Link.
Shake. Go! Green 18!
Pro Magnon boy.
Green 18!
Barnes completed four passes for 9 yards so far. That one complete after Sean Manuel, the tight end, seldom used as a pass catcher in this San Francisco offensive schematic. That's a gain of 15 and a first down for San Francisco.
Easy.
You got Tarzan in. Give me Tarzan left. Give me seven ocean.
Here we go. Tarzan left. Seven ocean on one, right?
Where's Jane at, Mike?
Go! Seven ocean. Hit it. 358. Miami. 358.
Juan Johnson has checked into the game. That's a gain of three. Juan Johnson has been injured for much of the latter portion of the season for San Francisco, and really a great story in that he, on his own nickel, chose to travel with the team down the stretch to be with his mates and cheer him on to victory to try and get into the postseason. You know, he wasn't on the roster, not earning any money, still forking over the cash for airfare to be with the guys.
Vaughn Johnson, number 26, for the love of the game.
Former Utah Ute in the backfield here on second and eight. A couple of yips at the line, hand to Kelvin Anderson. And a flag on the play.
Come on, baby.
I'm impressed with what Pat Barnes has done in the huddle, his control and command on this team, his leadership
take
in there,
we'll
keeping everybody under control.
We'll take it.
Falling behind 16-0.
Well, there's no reason for him to panic yet. There's a lot of time in this game. They march down
Upside.
Here. They
number
get points on the board again, and they're down to single-digit lead. Orlando.
Andre Purvis, the guy that flinched for Orlando.
Courtesy of Pat Barnes.
Who's up?
Inflection.
Tarzan right. Give me four Zorro.
Here we go. Tarzan left, four Zorro. On one, ready?
Second and short.
Not either Guy Williams or Johnny Weissmuller. Tarzan and Zorro both involved in this play.
That's Kelvin Anderson, and that's a first down for San Francisco. Patrice Alexander on the stop for Orlando.
Conspicuous in his absence from the Rage defensive front seven, number 51, linebacker James Burgess, who left the game after getting kicked in the ribs. Right now, San Francisco having success running between the tackles.
It's a hold that Burgess is generally there to stop on every play.
Go!
Barnes on the quick drop, got a receiver down the middle. That's Brian Roberson. Roberson's lost his helmet twice tonight. Doesn't matter if he catches it. I don't think he minds as much.
Brian Roberson up. Wide receiver that San Francisco Orlando did not have to take account of in the first game because he was injured and did not play, and he can make a difference for this ball team.
And there's another Rage player down on the field injured.
Reggie Doster, the guy that knocked the helmet off, and Roberson says, yeah, we bad, just like Gene Wilder and Richard Pryor in Stir Crazy.
He bad too.
Speaking of Stir Crazy.
They get like that by eating the meat. Yeah.
The Whopper says carnivores prefer flame broiled. In the land of burgers, the flame broiled Whopper is king.
Hey, it's time to clean up your act with new Edge Clean Shave Gel. Edge Clean's got a built-in facial cleanser. It helps lift dirt and oil from your face to the phone, cleaning while you shave. So clean up your act with new Edge Clean Shave Gel.
You know what they say about oysters. The same is true about tires. Enhance your performance at Pep Boys, where 35,000-mile tires are just $4 for $99, or 70,000-mile Futuras, $4 for $179. Fall in love with your car again at Pep Boys. Sweaty palms? Dry mouth? Yep, you love that car. Log on to PepBoys.com to enter the love of your life in the first-ever virtual car show. Come to Pep Boys for your official entry today. Fall in love with your car again at Pep Boys.
700, 3 weeks late. That's 15 large you owe me. Vinny, don't come out till something's broke.
Strong bones? Your bones grow until you're 35. Calcium helps keep them strong.
Is that all you got?
The XFL on NBC is brought to you by Burger King.
In the land of burgers, Whopper is king. By New Edge Clean Shaving Gel, it helps lift dirt and oil every time you shave. By Pep Boys, cars like us, people love us. And by Milk, with 9 essential nutrients. Got milk?
San Francisco trying to charge towards perhaps an end zone strike here with 10:21 left in the second quarter.
Red 43 yards,
into a drive.
Gunner, go! Set up!
Barnes with a little flip back to Terry Battle, trying to run the option play, and it didn't work. Cedric Clark jumped on it, and yesterday Pat Barnes told us he wasn't real comfortable with that particular play in the package. Perhaps we just saw why.
You know, every time San Francisco gets close to thinking they're getting back in this game, they shoot themselves right in the foot, step all of them. Look at that.
And if you're not accustomed to running the option, it's very difficult to pick up in just 1 week of time. It's all about spacing between yourself and the running back. I think Terry was charging the line of scrimmage a little bit, the space between him and Pat Barnes.
And I think it's also called looking the ball in before you start running.
Exhale all your air out.
Go!
Diallo Burks out of the blast in forward motion. Pass goes his way, and he drops the football. Been a rough night for Terry Battle.
Twice in the end zone on kickoff returns, and that play right there that gave Orlando the ball back.
Second and 10. San Francisco defense really hasn't had a chance to catch its breath, and Burks drops another one.
Same play.
Now, this happened last week with Brian Kuklick trying to get it out there to his receivers against Chicago. What's going through Kuklick's mind right now?
Z-0, 60 hooks on one, right?
You know, by the way, Diallo Burks is probably their best receiver threat.
Liz!
Not until he catches it.
Man. Third and 10 now after a couple of drops, and that one's flat out incomplete. Kevin Casebehar had the coverage on Skinny Culver, and Orlando is going to have to punt. What a disappointing way to gain possession after a turnover.
Swain, you're wide open. I mean, on Swain.
You know, let me tell you, it's a 13-point deficit, but Orlando's had a chance to really bury San Francisco tonight, and they have not been able to do it.
Frisco's defense is playing pretty well, really.
Flag on the play. Jimmy Cunningham starts the return in his end zone, and he's dropped at the 8.
We got 3 flags on the play.
Are you going to go around him, or are you going to call up the phone?
He's playing out here. He's playing over there, out yard, 8 yards.
All right. '97 white holding, what do you have?
We got red team. 54 downfield, too early on the kick.
So we got to bring it all back and just
play for a second. Sounded like they're going to replay the down.
Well, I got one guy giving the business. What do you got?
Ineligible receiver downfield, number 54, holding. Number 97, both penalties were offset. Repeat, fourth down.
Never mind.
Repeat, coach, fourth down.
I'm not sure who gets the advantage on this one.
Well, you figured Jimmy Cunningham's return gave San Francisco possession at the 8-yard line. It's tough to march him back any farther than that.
Got it. Then holding on us.
Coming up tonight on NBC, actress Renee Zellweger makes her Saturday Night Live debut with musical guest Eve. That's tonight's Saturday Night Live. Love her, by the way. My own added unsolicited commentary.
Ever since Jerry Maguire.
Here's Jimmy Cunningham now to start the return to the 2-yard line. And guess what? The same result.
We didn't even need to do it.
Shredder.
You need Shredder 2000.
That is right, folks. You need the Shredder 2000 to use on documents like this research report from 19... 19-
Whopper is king. The LA Extreme running back duo of Rashawn Sheehy and Saladin McCullough combined for 155 yards rushing in a 24-0 win over the Demons. McCullough had 73 yards and a TD in less than two quarters before being injured. Sheehy had 92 yards in relief. That was the Burger King XFL Offensive Player of the Week. In the land of burgers, Whopper is king.
A lonely seat for Terry Battle, who has had a rough start to this first-ever XFL playoff game. Demons take the field offensively without him to start things at their own 8-yard line. Barnes to throw, dumps it off to Kelvin Anderson, who misses one tackler, gets hit hard and dropped at the 21-yard line by Corey Gilliard.
And Terry, I know it's been a tough night holding on to the ball, but there may be a reason why.
Well, there's no excuses. I just need to get my head into the game. So I'm just trying to come back, having a hard time breathing right now. So next week, next half, I'm trying to make something up.
Terry Battle, we're told, is working on a case of bronchitis tonight. That is Corey.
Pistachio, go! 319!
And linebacking core is still without James Burgess, Orlando's leading tackler. Barnes gets it out to the one-man show, Kelvin Anderson once again. Sean Banks, big hands from Texas Tech, makes the tackle.
James, earlier you were kneed in the ribs. You're out here now. Your ribs are wrapped. What is your condition? Can you play?
I think I can play. We're going to go in halftime and see the suggestion, and if I feel like I can go out there and play, I'm going to come back and play.
Second and seven now.
He's breathing, Matt.
He'll be back. He's got heartbeat.
Green 88!
Out of the shotgun now, Barnes. Has a nice pocket to work from and gets a completion out to Brian Roberson.
And that time his helmet stayed on.
That'll be close to a first down for San Francisco.
Twins! Gun!
No need to measure.
Gunner,
they mark it as a first down for the Demons. And no need to huddle.
Gunner, go!
Back this other way.
In the hurry of offense out of the shotgun is Barnes again. He's flushed out of the pocket. Finding a target. Oh. It's Jimmy the Jet Cunningham, who can't hang on to the football.
I tell you, if you're a wide receiver with Pat Barnes throwing you the ball, you got to stay awake at all times. This guy is going to get off the hook. This guy is going to make a play. So if you're a wide receiver, hey, man, I could come to you at any time. You got to catch the football.
And we've seen a lot of drop passes tonight. The quarterbacks are throwing the ball on the money. The receivers are dropping them.
Galen Hall told us yesterday that he fears the elusiveness of the San Francisco skill position guys. Guys like Jimmy the Jet, guys like Kelvin Anderson, who really have to wrap up to tackle.
Time out. I want to time out. Oh, no, I just couldn't audible.
And Barnes burns San Francisco's second timeout. Orlando on top. We'll be right back.
In 5 billion years, Earth has never seen anything like it. The Honda Rubicon. 500 cc's of extraordinary power and the most advanced automatic ATV transmission to ever run the planet, the Honda Matic. when you're the best on Earth, Earth is your only competition.
So how are we getting home?
Good question.
Hop on in, guys.
File this under never. When you need a ride, save big bucks and dial 1-800-CALLATT for collect calls.
Hi, Tom Baudette. When did you see the light?
Going over to Phoenix. We wanted to rest up for the game, and suddenly it was so clear. Motel 6. I think it's great.
Well, you gotta call them like you see them. Call us and see the light for yourself.
You have just completed the culminating training event into the United States.
Back from the Citrus Bowl, just about 6 minutes left to play here in the first half. And San Francisco trying to put together a drive. Nothing more than a field goal so far for the Demons. Barnes rolling, flushed out once again and on the move. He has to eat it as he's taken down by Cedric Clark, a loss of a yard on the play. Well, as banged up as Orlando is defensively, they're without their leading tackler. We've already seen guys in their secondary go down. They're managing to keep the blankets pretty tight on the San Francisco receivers.
Makes refugees from Jacobs Field.
Makes it long for the guy at Cleveland Muni.
Barnes in trouble again.
And he can't get it away. Again, it's Cedric Clark right in the middle of the mayhem.
That just comes off like that, doesn't it?
Barnes keeps it in check. Punting unit on as Mike Panasek's on to kick it. It's a live ball at the 49-yard line.
Skinny left early.
A wobbler for Skinny Culver. Starts the return at the 43 and is knocked out with a flag at the 48-yard line. Plenty of flags, only four penalties so far tonight.
Oh, maybe that's him.
That's got to be an offensive coordinator on the phone.
Show, here's that.
Shoot. Yeah, I know. I lost vision of the guy inside. I wanted to get Travis. You know, because the corner's lying way outside, right at the touch, right at the first down depth. So. Yeah. All right. You got it. All right. Yeah.
The next best thing to being there. Joe Pau, the offensive coordinator, can't beat Pat Barnes, but he can tell him what to do and sees things that Pat doesn't see maybe down there.
Block in the back call on the punt return marches things back for Orlando, and nobody's close to that one.
Go.
What both these quarterbacks have in common, Pat Barnes
zero,
and Brian Kubelik,
here we go, 0-14, check 15, all one, right?
Is that each of them are aggressive, both of them are gamblers. Kubelik threw 10 picks in just three starts. That led the XFL, no, by the way.
Check, 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 check. Go!
Inside of 4 minutes now. This is Michael Black trying to get around Kevin Casebehar and finally brought down by Casebehar after a gain of seven.
This kind of cutback runs absolutely killed San Francisco a week ago when Los Angeles' Saladin McCullough did him in.
Let me tell you, the Orlando offense has hardly lit the world on fire. All their points came within the first 6 minutes of the game, and they came on gifts by San Francisco.
San Francisco's lost the game so far. Orlando hasn't won it.
Liz!
Kubelik is 0 for his last four passing. You got to factor in a couple of brutal drops in there. hangs it up in the corner for Diallo Burks and or Mario Bailey. It's incomplete.
And that offensive line for Orlando, their strong suit, absolutely caved in that time by San Francisco's front four. Kuklik never got the ball, had a chance to get the ball off, actually tripped over one of his own offensive linemen. Watch him backpedal there. His running back, actually, Michael Black. And then the pressure by strong safety Toby Wright on the blitz.
Look at this, bounce.
Whoa!
Taylor's got to go and run for it. It's still bouncing around. He still doesn't have control. He gets hit. It's a free ball. Who picks it up?
It don't matter. It's their ball. That's fourth down.
On fourth down, a change of possession indeed.
And finally, San Francisco gets a break.
Jermaine Miles, bad ankle and all, put the fear of everybody in Jay Taylor, and he couldn't find the handle on the football.
And maybe Mr. Murphy changed jerseys, too. Backup linebacker Ritz Young is the snapper, long snapper for the Orlando Rage.
That was long, all right. This is the kind of break Jim Skipper and the Demons have been looking for ever since the opening whistle. This is Kelvin Anderson hanging onto that football like it's its only child. He says he's in the end zone.
And the referee says no.
Big Hands Banks stopped him at the goal line.
Knee down before he's reached out and crossed the plane with the football. I like what Kelvin Anderson has been doing for this San Francisco offense tonight.
And I say you give the ball right back to Kelvin again. There's the handoff. Kelvin sees his opening, drives to the goal line. A good call by the official. Very good. He was not in.
Kelvin Anderson was acquired.
Fumble
in the end zone.
Do you believe that? Do you? No, they're calling it a touchdown. They're saying he broke the plane. Oh, is this crowd going to get mad on that one?
A quarterback sneak by Pat Barnes. He tried to wheel it in with that extra inch. The ball popped free. Let's take a look.
One of the refs called it a touchdown. He broke the plane.
The touchdown is confirmed.
1 point in the center. In the center.
And San Francisco is going to try a 1 point conversion.
Keep this in mind about tonight's officials. This group was voted here by the head of officiating, Carl Pagnalli. They were rated based on their performance this year. They are here on the merit of their gamesmanship during the course of this season.
Who made the call, Vince?
A bad snap on fourth down with the punting team on the field gave San Francisco possession inside the 10.
San Francisco has one timeout remaining.
A controversial
Orlando
touchdown call. And now San Francisco takes a timeout.
Noise is going to be a factor.
Oh, this is getting good. Inside of 2 minutes and a half, and we'll be right back.
Stay home. I don't care. God
only has. We got somebody. Great.
Hold it.
Thanks.
21, please.
Like playing around with stuff? Well, at Best Buy, you can play around with anything you want. Actually, that's half the fun. Best Buy, go ahead, turn on the fun.
Hey, check it out, a totally twisted way to eat pizza.
Yeah, new Twisted Crust Pizza from Pizza Hut. It's breadsticks.
No, it's pizza.
It's both.
Look, go directly to the Twisted Crust and tear off a breadstick.
Dude, what planet are you from? You eat your pizza first and you save your breadsticks till the end.
No, it's breadsticks first, then the free marinara or ranch dipping sauce, then pizza.
You're twisted. Pizza first.
The new Twisted Crust Pizza from Pizza Hut. Breadsticks and pizza together at last.
I got one word for you. Breadsticks.
That's two words, Brainiac.
Another one of the best pizzas under one roof.
On May 4th, Universal Pictures will take you to a world where mystery comes to life. The past is reborn. And the adventure never dies. The Mummy returns. Rated PG-13. At theaters Friday, May 4th.
And if you feel it in your toes and you won't stop,
And if it's deep in your soul, then you can't stop. And if you know what I know, then you won't stop. We're going way up, way up, way up, way up.
Controversy in Orlando after a quarterback sneak results in a touchdown call. The Cleveland refugees just want to bang their drum all day. Guy on the right scares me. And San Francisco will line up for a one-point conversion try.
319! 319!
This is as riled up as the Orlando fans have been all night, and the reason for that is because San Francisco, after a big deficit to start tonight, trails by only six.
Nice call, Joe. All right, hold it up. Let's line up. Line up. Hey, get in the V so we can see who's here. Line up. Back up. Let's line up. Hey, listen. Let's create another turnover. Now, let's go get out. Let's get down there and blow him up. Blow him up!
Hey, watch the fake.
Jim Skipper coach teams thrive on emotion, and they certainly have snatched it out of the jaws of what was once a 16-0 deficit. It's worth noting at this point, guys, that the biggest deficit San Francisco overcame all year was only 6 points.
Let's go.
Undeterred, they are on the way back tonight. Mike Panasek on to kick it with 1:55 left in the half. Brian Shea, the deep return man for Orlando. Here's Shea at the 11. Fumble. The ball's loose. Let's sort out the pile. And San Francisco recovers.
Wow.
Oh, my goodness.
They could have the lead before the half.
This is the screwiest this XFL game I've seen all year long. Such reversal of fortunes. Marvin Coleman and Wendell Davis were in to scoop it up. Here's where Shea coughed up the football.
Oh, it's loose all the way. Total fumble, no doubt about that one.
Marvin Coleman gathered it in, and San Francisco takes over at the 26.
Go!
Another chance for Pat Barnes. They've got the tight end set in now with the fullback Jamie Reeder back there. Play action to Kelvin Anderson. And Barnes in the corner.
Where is he?
Had a man wide open, and it's picked off by Kelly Malvo. The former University of Arizona Wildcat.
Brian Shea off the hook. Sure where Pat Barnes was looking at here.
I have no idea. There wasn't any receiver anywhere around.
Right behind, immediately behind Kelly Malvo was a receiver. And there was no pressure really on Pat.
That's two big mistakes by Barnes in this game. One giving Orlando a touchdown, and this one possibly costing them a touchdown.
Boy, you'd think these two teams are playing for a chance to get into the million-dollar game or something. Here's a handoff to Derek Clark up the middle for a couple of yards to give the Orlando offense a little breathing room.
I got a feeling Galen Hall's going to just be happy to let this half run out and go in with a six-point lead.
Back up.
Looks like I picked the wrong night to stop sniffing glue.
Mike Black!
The battle away from the battle between wide receiver and defensive back. The veteran Dwayne Harper getting his legs cut out from underneath him. And veterans don't like that.
Yeah. Dwayne Harper saying, listen, Kevin Swain, I'm older, I'm wiser, and more cunning than you are. Again, Derek Clark. Ulbrich battled in on the stop for San Francisco. Nephew of...
Nobody using timeouts here. Frisco with one left could stop the clock once more and try to get the ball back, but apparently they don't want to.
Do you want to hear how Aubrey battles the nephew of Sidney Moncrief, Jess?
Sure.
A great story.
Tell us.
Aubrey battles the nephew of Milwaukee Buck great Sidney Moncrief.
And when we asked him about it, he didn't know it, right? Am I in his will?
Third and six now, in San Francisco just takes their final timeout of the half.
Now, why do you wait, Mike, 15 seconds to call that timeout? Why would you call it right when the play's over?
Got it? Hey.
Now, courtesy of Busch Beer, let's take a look at how the San Francisco Demons got here.
Winning is what bonds a team together. Feel what it's going to feel like when we win this thing. Knowing we're going to the playoffs. Knowing we got a shot. Feel that right now.
The Demons faced the Outlaws with a playoff berth on the line. They got an early score off special teams, and later Mike Pulaski hit Terry Battle for a 25-yard touchdown to send the Outlaws home and the Demons to the dance.
Oh. Right out.
Jim Skipper's Demons have had their backs to the wall seemingly all year long.
I want to get out of here. Yep. It's all right with it.
What's Skip say? I wish we could get out of here. I don't think he's talking about the Citrus Bowl. I think he's talking about this half.
All right. Nice. That's going to be the quarter.
Final seconds tick away on an unusual half of football. In the end, it's just a six-point contest as the teams go to the locker rooms. This thing is wide open. It's anybody's chance to go to the million-dollar game with a win tonight. We'll be back after this word from your local NBC stations. Fumbles, interceptions, bad snaps.
1-800.
Ace.
Let's take a look at our halftime stats brought to you by Miller Genuine Draft. The turnovers, the big story. Four of them by San Francisco. Minus nine rushing yards by the three-headed running back monster of Orlando.
You know, you look at that and you see Orlando's offense has done nothing, and yet they got the lead in the game.
That was San Francisco's game plan, too. We'll stop your run. Brian Kuklick, try to beat us if you can.
That pass is complete to Mario Bailey, tackled by Dwayne Harper. Last time these two teams met, Orlando ran for 140 yards en route to a 26-14 win. Minus rushing total in the first half, yet because of the turnovers, they're still on top by six.
First down. 0-14, first down. Ready?
That's the three-headed monster. They have not accomplished much.
It doesn't look like much of a monster to me, Matt. Not the first half.
This is Michael Black taking a hand up the middle. Tackled by Craig Powell as a heavy fog from the pyrotechnics covers the field of play.
Orlando also 0-for-5 on third down conversions in the first half.
Look at this. It's like the halftime of Super Bowl IV where they recreated the War of 1812.
Where's Oliver Stone?
Check. 960 choice.
0-50 draw, check, 960 choice, on one, right?
Kuklick has a chance now to run one of two plays, a draw play here, or check off to a pass play with six-man protection.
No!
Receivers have their choice of running the short route. Good enough to make the first down. They run the draw instead.
Michael Black, nothing doing. Jermaine Miles, Eric England and company in on the tackle, and a three and out is how Orlando starts the second half.
And I'll tell you, the Big Mo is switching here. The Big Mo is switching to San Francisco momentum.
Galen Hall told us how active the defense is up front for San Francisco. They've really done their job. They're not the ones coughing up the football.
No, you think the snapper's a little worried? He got that one right in there.
Jay Taylor just gets it away before Jermaine Miles could get his face. Here's Jimmy Cunningham now caught it right on his pad, and he turns it upfield, tackled at the 31. 46-yard punt, 8 yards on the return. There was some crazy play in the first half tonight. The bad snap, and that explains the negative rushing yards for Orlando tonight. And then right after that, 2 plays later, the controversial touchdown on the sneak by Pat Barnes. The result is a 6-point game here in the second half.
Green 19. Tut.
Jamie Reeder, the man in motion. Kelvin Anderson takes the handoff. And he makes something out of nothing. A gain of 4 before they James can. Roberson gets to him.
They can't.
Ritter left stay. Nine, Ritter left stay. Nine, Tom Pipe on one, right?
Look for
go, Green 19.
Green 19. Set. Go.
Pitch back to Kelvin Anderson. Breaks number of tackles and gets it up near the 40-yard line. A gain of 4 yards again.
58. I thought you was ready. I thought you was ready.
He's talking to Patrice Alexander, the Orlando linebacker.
Go!
They can't tackle me!
He's right about that. Omar Brown can't tackle him. Patrice Alexander can't tackle him. Got those Earl Campbell thighs.
Peter Elisara is the player down on the running play.
And if we had a best hair category, there's my pick.
On that note, just log on to XFL.com. We'll create one. We'll be right back.
The down marker. What's he doing? Ball's way up here.
On 39. Couple of yards by Kelvin Anderson.
It's going to depend on the spot, but I think they got it.
How valuable has Kelvin Anderson become to San Francisco's offense? This is a guy that they've only had for half the season, yet he's their leading rusher this year.
I can see why. He runs the ball hard. He protects it well.
Here we go. Doubles left. 65.
Fairly good speed on the corner. Runs tough inside the tackles.
He had planned to go back to school at Southeast Missouri State to pursue his criminal justice degree before coming back to football, and he could not have made a better decision, according to the Demons.
Average not great, but those are 26 important yards that he has gained.
Barnes up top, a lot of contact on the field, and a flag.
All over the place.
He was looking for Titus Winans. Reggie Doster had the coverage.
It is the one element that was missing from San Francisco's attack last week, throwing the ball deep. And again, even if you don't complete the pass, at least you give the sensation that you can go deep.
On the defense. Spot foul. Grabbed him by the shirt. David,
did you not see him grab him by the shirt? Did you not see the receiver grab him? David!
Obviously he didn't.
David's ignoring him. David, of course, that official that made the call. I don't know about a shirt grab. There was plenty of contact. Well, there's the shirt grab.
19!
A big first down for San Francisco on a penalty, however, as they take over at the 31. Here's Kelvin Anderson, a familiar theme around the left side. Good for a couple of yards.
He's got that. that all you got looking in your face?
Bring it. Bring some more.
The important thing
is left. Good.
4 yards on first down, 5 yards on first down.
We going to the right.
You stay in. You stay in.
Yeah.
Fifth play of the drive, second and five now for San Francisco. Barnes out of the shotgun. Roberson was the man in motion. It's complete to Brian Roberson with plenty of room to run. Tackled at the 10. A gain of 15 for the Demons before Sean Banks could get there.
And he'd have got more if Travis Moore hadn't missed a downfield block, because Travis Moore was in position to make a great block downfield, and he missed it.
By and large,
watch
these Demons
this,
wide receivers, yeah, they're pretty
good
downfield
blockers. Look
at, here's
Moore down there, and he misses the block.
Yep. Got to do better than that, Travis.
Brian Roberson, so far the Demons' leading receiver. He was inactive week two when these two teams met. That was something we talked about earlier. He's already made a difference tonight. Little pass out the flat to Jimmy the Jet Cunningham. Great speed after the catch. He almost gets himself into the end zone.
And he's hurt after that dive, too. He lost his helmet.
Oh, the Demons' leading receiver and a man they can ill afford to miss.
Hopefully, he just got the wind knocked out of him.
Sometimes you pay the price for extra effort.
And we may be finding out if Orlando can come from behind. We know they can in the regular season, but we may find out whether they can in the playoffs. Jimmy the Jet looks like he lost an engine.
It's a guy who caught at least two passes in every regular season game this year.
They lose him, San Francisco down to just three wide receivers.
I think he's going to be back.
And it's tough to tell what happened there, the extra athletic ability of Jimmy the Jet being shown there, but that's also what paid the price. A timeout on the field, San Francisco driving. We'll be right back.
You are watching NBC, network of the NBA playoffs and NBA finals.
Let's do it.
These guys don't look so tough.
Heads up.
I got your back. On your left.
Go, go, go.
I'm hot, baby.
For a spin.
Gatorade, bring your game to life.
I'll take the big guy.
Which big guy?
It takes a lot to keep our aircraft flying. Nearly 750,000 remarkable individuals. Our people are the fuel we run on. Join us. America's Air Force. No one comes close.
He's a man with talent.
Call the doctor!
I have a real doctor. See, look.
All he needs is his family's support.
You miserable, pathetic loser!
Is this your dad?
His girlfriend's love.
Betty, stop it!
And a little shove. In the right direction.
I can run backwards faster than you can. Now the backwards man.
Tom Green.
What God's name are you doing?
Freddy got fingered. Rated R. Friday only in theaters.
I know, you practically live here. The odometer even says so. Well, maybe it's time for a little homeowner's insurance. Unless you prefer spending time with used car salesmen. Look, the solution's clear. New Quaker State higher mileage engine for engines with 75,000 miles or more. It's specially formulated to help prevent leaks, oil consumption, and loss of compression. So if you don't want to stop at 75,000 miles, then don't. New Quaker State higher mileage engine. What more do you need to know?
the Triple Crown, one of sports' most coveted titles, held by legends like Secretariat, Seattle Slough, and Affirm. But no horse has been successful in nearly a quarter century. Will this be Point Given's year to make history? The Visa Triple Crown begins with the Kentucky Derby, Saturday, May 5th on NBC.
Jimmy, the Jet Cunningham, the Demons' leading receiver, sidelined for the moment. We'll check in as to the extent of the injury in a moment. Meanwhile, second and goal for San Francisco on the Orlando 1. They try to sneak it in again. This time a lot less controversial. Touchdown, San Francisco.
Oh, absolutely.
Well, a tie game now, and now the postseason rules come into play again. What does Jim Skipper want to do as far as a PAT try?
You go for one from the one.
Just go for one. Yeah,
absolutely. You go for the lead the easiest way you can get it.
You guys are for me. To recap the rule, for those of you just tuning in late in the postseason, the XFL PAT rules are different. A one-point conversion from the one-yard line on a runner pass, as per usual. But you can also try for a two-point conversion from the five or a three-point conversion from the 10. And San Francisco's taking a timeout.
Hey, you called something that we never... What's the call? They call something that was not on our play sheet.
And now, Burger King presents the XFL Defensive Player of the Week. In the land of burgers, Whopper is king. New York hitman corner Joey Elams intercepted two passes against the Bolts in a 22-0 shutout win. One was converted into a score when he lateraled off to Donnie Caldwell, who took it in for a touchdown. Elams ended the season number two in interceptions with four overall. That was the Burger King XFL Defensive Player of the Week. In the land of burgers, Whopper is king.
We talked about it with both coaches yesterday, that. And Jim Skipper told us you let the game dictate what you do on the PAT. And as you guys mentioned, I kid you about it, this is no time to get fancy with the three-point conversion attempt.
Well, you know, when you look at both coaches, Jim Skipper looks very relaxed right now on the sidelines. Galen Hall does not look that way on the Orlando side of the field.
Galen's got the look of a man who's just seen his team blow a 16-0 lead. With no signs of generating any kind of offense to regain that lead.
All 16 Orlando points within the first 5 minutes of the game.
Go! 319! Miami, Miami!
This is a point after attempt for San Francisco to try and break the tie. Play action to Calvin Anderson, a pass into the corner.
No good.
And the PAT is incomplete.
Why do you throw with a running back like that from the one? Oh.
We'll answer these and other questions when we return.
You have just completed the culminating training event on the road into the United States Army. I want you to think about what it took to get here. I want you to think about the pain and the gain of Victory Forge, and I want you to think about the light and the heat of the fire burning before you. This fire is an eternal flame. It represents the soldiers who have completed basic combat training before you and those who are yet to come. The fact that you are standing here means that you have what it takes to be a soldier in the greatest army of the world.
Log on and find out what it feels like. Only at GoArmy.com.
Hey, it's time to clean up your act with New Edge Clean Shave Gel. Edge Clean's got a built-in facial cleanser. It helps lift dirt and oil from your face to the phone, cleaning while you shave. So clean up your act with new Edge Clean Shave Gel.
I left my project at home.
It is 80% of your final grade.
Excuse me. I think our friend deserves an A.
You got that?
This could happen. Emphasis on could. When you're in a jam, save big bucks and dial 1-800-CALLATT for collect calls.
Never once did your car ask you for flowers. Never once did it ask you if it looks fat. Or did it get mad at you for leaving the seat up? Doesn't it deserve something special in return?
Next Saturday, a monumental battle will rage. Two teams will leave it all on the field. For one, heartbreak and despair. For the other, tears of victory and 1 million reasons to celebrate. The Million Dollar Game. NBC next Saturday.
At one point tonight, the Orlando Rage led 16-0. San Francisco, as they've done all season, has clawed their way back in this thing. We're tied over the third. And the man returning the kick, almost beheaded by Otis Floyd, Stephen Fisher, just got his head knocked off.
Now, I'm not so sure when you're on the one-yard line, you got a back like Kelvin Anderson who's ripping holes through your the defense. You run a play like this, you got to go for 3 points there with a...
Coach, you're back in this thing, but with all due respect, the rationale behind the call on the point after, what was it?
Well, what happened was we called a formation that Pat wasn't sure of, so he called a timeout so we wouldn't screw it up. Because you never know, at 16-16, that might have been the winning point, so that ain't a bad timeout.
But a pass play there at the end when you're on the one-yard line.
Hey, you can call run or pass. Hey, anything goes. If it goes, then it's good. It don't matter what you call.
I think that's...
Don't?
Well, that Skip's way of saying if it worked, that was a genius, so get out of my face.
Yeah.
Go!
We have not seen much of Kuklik and the Orlando offense. This is Michael Black, and they got nothing going on with the running game tonight. A loss of a yard on the play. Eric England and Pete Talamamao there for the tackle.
They were open about it. They were bold about it. We're going to game plan this thing. We're going to put 8 men in the box, 9 men in the box. You try to run it against us, you won't be able to. So, Brian Kuklik, you've got to do your job at quarterback and beat us, and so far he has not.
There's Big Penny. Big Penny Talamavau making a start tonight. Nothing on the ground for Orlando tonight. That story was just the opposite first time these two teams met, and Eric England is there to put his mitts on that pass and knock it down.
Clearly not the same team we saw earlier in the year with Jeff Brohm at quarterback.
What's up, mama?
And Eric England's wishing he had that play over again, because that had nothing but 6 points written all over it had he just caught it.
Hey, you know what? In defense of Brian Kuklik, he made only 3 starts.
Here we go. Zero,
and passed
50,
for exactly
one
60, yard 60, less 60, 60, than 60. Jeff Brohm did all season long in 6-plus starts. But he is one of his last 7 here tonight. Third and long.
Flag.
And the yips on the line of scrimmage. Eric England is claiming he was drawn offsides.
Third and 17, Mike.
I don't think he was in the neutral zone. That's what I want to ask you. I don't think he's in the neutral zone.
Hey, Pete! Peter! Hey, Pete! 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 Hey, Pete! Pete! Watch the screen! Tell him!
That's Dan Goodspeed. Penalty on Orlando. I'll tell you what, this is not the Orlando team that went 8-2 during the regular season and did it virtually mistake-free all year long.
And they're facing third and long now. They're 0-for-6 on third down conversions tonight. Pathetic for the Orlando Rage.
Go!
Again, third and long, a passing formation. Kuklik buys some time as the tacklers tackle themselves, and the pass is incomplete. Looking for Diallo Burks.
And it also in danger of maybe losing their best asset, and that's their home field advantage, the fans they have here in the Citrus Bowl.
They've been taken out of it since late in the first quarter. And here's the punting unit once again. Jimmy Cunningham is checked back in the game. He's back to return the punt of Jay Taylor.
He's got that elbow taped up, and he starts the return at his own 18-yard line. Tackled after a gain of 7. Coming up tonight on NBC.
Hi, I'm Renee Zellweger, and after tonight's game, I'm hosting Saturday Night Live with musical guest Eve.
You complete me.
Horatio, we talked about this.
You had me from. Get out of my dressing room or I'll spray you with mace.
Security!
First and 10 for Pat Barnes and the Demons. A line that started out nothing but ugly is suddenly looking more and more respectable the deeper we get into this ballgame.
16!
Hand to Kelvin Anderson. Mark Campbell in on the tackle after a gain of 3.
The guy giggling it at the bottom.
I'm loving this.
I'm loving this.
Pat.
Guys, look at the total yards. San Francisco 166, Orlando 24. Mike, go suit up for him.
I'm not sure I would help even at
that. Paul, at 24 yards, you could double that. I know you could.
Well, the Rage en route to their win over San Francisco in week 2, almost 300 total yards of offense. And again, we're talking about a team that went 8-2 during the regular season. They have been nothing but quiet since midway through the first.
First and 10, go 8-60 hook. All right.
Coach Galen Hall's already talking about their next possession.
It looks like he's going to take over the offense there.
Run 19.
Third and 8 for Pat Barnes.
Run
San Francisco
19.
Is 2-for-5 in third down conversions tonight. Dumps it off to you-know-who, and Kelvin Anderson's wrapped up. Patrice Alexander, he's the guy that runs the grill when the Orlando defense has a cookout, comes up with a big stop.
Patrice needs to pick up some of the emotional slack left behind when James Burgess, the Orlando Rage's fine outside linebacker, had to leave the game.
So Mike Panasek on to punt. A live ball at the 46-yard line. Skinny Culver's the deep man for Orlando. Great hang time on the punt. Culver's there to begin the return at the 22. He's tripped up and stumbles across to the 33-yard line. Well, the Orlando offense gets another shot.
Come on. Zero, 60 hooks on one, right?
60 refers to the pass protection. Six-man protection, all the wide receivers, three of them in this case, running the hook pass.
Kuklik over the middle. It bounces off the shoulder pads of Mario Bailey. Can't believe he got it in there to begin with.
Yeah, Kuklik with a lot of confidence,
you know,
coverage.
A lot of young quarterbacks suffer from the Superman complex. They love their arms. They fall in love with their arms. They think that they can thread the ball through any needle. The more you play this game, the more you realize you have respect for the defensive backs.
And right now, it's critical not to turn the ball over.
Go!
3 minutes in ticking here in the third quarter. And that one's dropped.
And there's another thing in Brian's defense. He's had his best receivers, in that case there, Kevin Swain, but also D'Alio Burks tonight, drop balls.
Well, I think here, Kevin Swain was looking at Kevin Casebehard running him down. Yeah. You're going to get hit either way, though, right? Catch the football.
Zero tray, 960, 2-on-2, seam, all one, right?
Brian Kuklik started out the night 4 of his first 5. He's 1-for-10 since.
Rip, 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 rip!
But again, a lot of those passes have been dropped balls. Looking at a 3rd and 10 here. That one batted up in the air.
Intercepted.
There's the turnover.
Oh. Kobe Wright, who was acquired by San Francisco from Las Vegas and just recently played his way into the starting lineup, comes up with a big pick.
The young man from Wake Forest has a very valid point.
It was only a matter of time. Any quarterback would get a little bothered with all the drops that Kukoc has seen tonight. You can continue to love your receivers for so long. Here's Kelvin Anderson again hanging on to the
football for
dear life. And Blake's a big one, tackled at the 36 by Corey Gilliard.
I'll tell you, I'm very impressed with Kelvin Anderson's running.
Let's go back to the interception a moment ago.
Mario Bailey, the intended receiver. Kukoc put it there, maybe a hair behind him, but again, a catchable ball. And Bailey tips, and the result is San Francisco interception.
Shift the drill right. No, shift the drill left for Zorro. I'm one, ready? Go ball, go
ball. Kevin Casebaharn in the middle of that once again.
Go!
After the first down run by Kelvin Anderson.
Easy, easy. Red, red,
Barnes and the Demons at their own 37, rather at Orlando's 37. They spend their second time out of the half.
Ooh, and that could be troublesome, using up those timeouts in the third quarter.
How about San Francisco? Open up your golden gate.
I hear you, Connie.
Demons Jim, coming back.
I hear you. I'm with you.
As a touchdown boogie coordinator, I'm called upon to be a miracle worker. Like this one kid, Nebraska. This guy is rhythmless.
What do you think you're doing?
So, you know, I worked on him, broke him down.
That's a chicken, but it's not funky.
Build him back up until the moment that I saw him out there, he's proud like a father. When a father sees his little boy grow up and become a ballet dancer.
Bud Light celebrates those who like to celebrate.
She's a real beauty. And she never bugs you about spending so much time with the guys. She never complains about you watching football. She thinks a little gas is a good thing. Maybe she isn't a she after all. Here's to the perfect relationship. Here's how to keep it that way.
Play real football, my kind of football, raw survival in the mud and snow. No domes, no fair catches, no phony grass. It's harsh, it's bruising, so it's beautiful. Think you're tough enough to play my kind of football? Then come and get it.
Introducing the official game ball of the XFL from Spalding, the toughest football ever.
Come on, Johnny. Oh, Johnny's mom is calling up.
Pain, sacrifice, risk, all for a shot at $1 million.
The best team in the XFL, guys.
They won four straight.
I don't think nobody's going to stop us right now.
One team stands between them and the million-dollar game.
Division champs, baby!
The Western Division champion Extreme continue to light up the scoreboard and have million-dollar dreams of their own. The Enforcers, the Extreme, the XFL playoffs, Sunday on UPN.
The Knicks. Every game's crucial in the playoff scramble. The Sixers, Iverson, and the top team in the East stand in their way. Sunday, noon Eastern, NBC.
The Olympic Winter Games from Salt Lake. Coming in 300 days on America's Olympic Network, NBC.
Score tied at 16. San Francisco driving in the third quarter. And what you're watching is backup quarterback Jim Arianez taking snaps on the Orlando sideline. Ryan Kukoc has been ineffective tonight. Not entirely his fault.
Jim, the next time the Rage has the ball, you'll be in at quarterback. What will you attempt to do? What are your thoughts?
Just going to try and come in, spark this offense and get something going. We're sputtering a little bit. Maybe this change will help us move the ball.
In the playoffs, do you feel any pressure in this situation?
No pressure whatsoever.
And if you believe that, Jesse.
I was just going to say that. Mike, do you believe that?
Note that four drop balls, and we saw Brian Kukulik finally finally air out his receivers on the sideline. That might be part of the decision, too. That pass complete to Brian Roberson, who is in the midst of a big receiving night for San Francisco.
Jim Arianes has yet to take a single down, a snap from scrimmage this year in the XFL.
I think more important the question is how many snaps has he taken in practice? That's what you really got to ask, too.
Final seconds tick away on the third quarter as the plot thickens in Orlando. Don't go anywhere. You're watching the XFL playoffs on NBC.
Yeah, Ruffer lands, and we had a draw check going. They were zero straight across the board, 6 yards deep.
Thursday, an all-new night of must-see TV with a friend so outrageous, so hysterical, it's destined to become a Friends classic.
I tell you, that has never happened before.
Plus, special guest Denise Richards in the first of five all-new episodes leading up to the big wedding. Plus, all-new episodes of Weber and all-new Stevie, Will, and Grace.
That is so hot.
And all-new Just Shoot Me. We'll have to explain this. All-new must-see TV, NBC Thursday.
It's a celebration of building some of America's most coveted, most memorable, and most inspired cars. It's a celebration of knowing excitement matters. Welcome to Pontiac's 75th. Drive a wide-track Grand Prix during our 75th anniversary. See your Pontiac dealer now and lease a 2001 Grand Prix SE for as low as $277 a month. Call for important lease details. See why wider is better. Get to the celebration at your Pontiac dealer now.
Tonight at 10.
First thing I thought was this guy just killed us.
The Navy crew held in China for 11 days speaks out about their ordeal, then reunites with grateful loved ones for the first time since their release.
And a chilly but clear Easter morning. Thunderstorms could move in before the end of the day. I'll have your forecast.
And his incredible creation will soon teach history lessons in a national museum. Join us tonight at 10.
Honey, we're out of milk.
No problem.
With its powerful V6 engine, sporty double wishbone suspension, and luxurious drive, the Honda Accord will put the joy back in the ride.
Here you go, hon.
Honey, this is chocolate milk.
The Accord V6, another special value now at your Honda dealer. For a limited time, get special APR financing as low as 3.9% for 36 months on new Accords.
Joyful reunions between the crew of a spy plane and their families tonight at 10.
This is the XFL on NBC.
Well, we're 15 minutes of football away from knowing which of these two teams gets a chance to play in the $1 million championship game. That is, unless, of course, it goes into overtime. We don't even want to think about that. Look out, Pat Barnes. He gets it away and has a completion. He finds Travis Moore with people up in his kitchen.
And I think Travis got just enough for the first down. Big play for... And a lot of cramps out there. You can see him working on the leg right away. You got to take those fluids, Mike. You know that from your Ironman experience.
Look at Barnes. Pat Barnes now the trainer of the San Francisco Demons.
At one point in the game, he carried off one of his injured players, teammates, to the sideline. Now he's massaging this guy's calf. The more things you can do, Matt.
I love this guy. Seriously. I mean, Pat Barnes plays with such nerve, if you will. I can think of another word for that, but nerve is probably the more appropriate, you know, family term.
And you're right, you touched upon it earlier. Everybody thought that this team might be in trouble with the loss of Mike Pawlowski, but this guy, every bit the same kind of leader that Mike is.
Waco, you want me to just run a go out there?
Because it's 33, you see 33 out there again.
I know.
But just
I don't have time, that's the issue.
But just think about it.
Kelvin Anderson has been a big cog in this offense tonight. Use me, you can, anyway, I'll catch the ball, I'll run the ball, do whatever you want with it.
Well, as I said earlier, Anderson's really impressed me. He's very versatile. He's tough as nails. You can tell he likes to hit.
So we talked to Kelvin yesterday. You know, he told us he was just waiting to get down here. He was chomping at the bit to get into the XFL until his free agency was declared in Canada. He couldn't join the XFL. Once that happened, the Demons became a completely different team. Tune in tomorrow starting at 12 noon Eastern, an action-packed NBA triple header. First up, the Knicks look to stay in the race for the third spot in the East as they take on the Sixers. Then out West, it's the Jazz and Wolves. And in the nightcap, a possible playoff preview between the Blazers and the Lakers. All the action tomorrow at 12 noon Eastern.
Matt, I'm considered out West, Minnesota.
Well, I think in terms of the basketball world, you're an island unto yourself.
Wait a minute. You're from Milwaukee. you're not that far from me.
Well, you are an island unto yourself, though, Jesse. The Wolves are considered out West.
Okay.
Western Conference.
That's right. The Target Center's west of the Mississippi.
That's right.
So we got it covered.
Travis Moore being escorted off the field after making that grab.
In fact, Matt, I'll be there. I've been a season ticket holder now for about 7 years.
Not a bad basketball team either.
Oh, Garnett's always fun.
First and 10. Here's Calvin Anderson. Penetration into the back.
Oh, Calvin.
Ricky Bell couldn't tackle him. Rich Young finally hammered him out of bounds.
Calvin not happy with the play call. Didn't want to run the sweep. Wants to run inside those tackles.
Easy.
A loss of four on the play.
Tarzan left. 35. Dallas, backside 28 to the left on one. Ready? You got Dallas.
Pat Barnes has completed 10 of his last 13 passes.
Green 18. Hands up.
Over the middle and incomplete, looking for Jimmy Cunningham.
Threw it behind Cunningham. Cunningham was open, but Barnes
second
not
window.
Delivering on that one.
Cunningham again, bear in mind, playing with a bad elbow. There have been injury casualties and significant ones on both sides of the ball.
Here we go. Shift. No, you're fine.
Injuries that could linger well into next week and could be factors should one of these two teams advance to the million-dollar game.
The Demons without their triple threat running back, Terry Bass, battling bronchitis. This is Calvin Anderson. This is between the tackles. And this is a positive yardage play, a gain of 7.
Well, what it does, too, it gets them in the field goal range. All they're looking at right now, Jim Skippers, get the lead. They had a long way to go. And let that kicker come in and try to put him in front and see if Orlando can play from behind.
Well, already tonight, Mike Panasek has hit a 42-yarder. Already this season, Panasek has won a game with 2 seconds left. That was week one of the XFL season. A former school teacher from Lebanon, Indiana.
This one just a little under 40.
He was reading Beowulf in a drama class a few months ago, and this one is right through. San Francisco has come back to take a 3-point lead. They trailed at one point, 16-0. We'll be right back.
Well, lucky you came along. Most people wouldn't stop out here at night.
And they prey on the living.
She's infected.
What do you mean, infected? How?
They will possess you.
You kill the source of the origin, and you kill the strain.
The Forsaken.
Open the trunk.
Rated R. Opens everywhere, April 27th.
The Weekend Warrior. These men don't play for money. They don't play for glory. They play for the love of the game.
No, we don't. We do it for them.
Well, then, if you're trying to impress an XFL cheerleader, I suggest you huddle up with Stacker 2. Stacker 2 is the safe, smart way to burn fat and get an extra boost of energy. Stacker 2, the most valuable fat burner.
Tom Green here at Muscle Beach with some big, tough weightlifters.
We're going to show how Weight Guard Extreme Sport works even under the most extreme conditions.
Back, stop! Uh-oh. Run! Oh, no, the kid's going to get you! He got ya! Look, extreme protection against odor and wetness. Goes on clear and it doesn't quit. Kitty.
Right Guard Extreme Sport. Get extreme. Get Right Guard.
Ouch.
And if you feel it in your toes, then you won't stop. And if it's deep in your soul, then you can't stop. And if you know what I know, then you won't stop. We're going way up, way up, way up, way up.
Well, he said he wasn't going to settle for anything less than six. The only thing he didn't have in mind was a San Francisco six.
I don't mean to laugh at a man's misfortune. Dwayne Harper told us yesterday one of the reasons why he's still playing football at the age of 35 is his smarts.
Get away, Bardo, motherfucker, away.
Hey, we're going right back now. Let's go.
And the crowd here is stunned, guys. Ball, they're stunned.
They're out of it.
Don't worry about it. Don't worry about it.
What, the guy just squat?
They're here in body, but not in mind. They got nothing to think.
Go!
Here's the PAT try from Kelvin Anderson from 1 yard out.
Again, okay.
And it's good.
Let's go. It's not over.
Let's call that a rookie mistake on the part of Jim Arianis. He locked in on this receiver. Dwayne Harper read his eyes. He saw the wide receiver break down, and he jumped all over it, man. Kevin Swain breaks down.
I told you what.
And you know, Mike, that's why you do the tip drills on defense for plays just like that.
The once invincible Orlando Rage at home, 5-0 coming into this game.
Yeah, give it a go.
It was too quick and too easy at the start.
Maybe they pulled this guy too early. Removed to start the quarter. Jim Arianis throws the pick. Dwayne Harper's the hero of the moment, but he's got good company in terms of the San Francisco comeback.
And there's a lot of football left.
Scott Kloman takes the kickoff. Another chance for Arianis.
Jim, go 0-960. 939 angle.
Hey, let's go. Let's go. Let's go. 0-960. 939 angle. On one. Ready?
There's Jeff Blom. Their starter through the first 6 weeks of the season. The guy who was perhaps en route to MVP honors before he was taken down for the year. Arianna's next pass. This one's complete to Mario Bailey. They keep him in bounds, the clock ticking. John Haskins, Abdul Salam Noah on the tackle. A little cheeky out there.
Tempers are flaring out there because I'll tell you, you can read it all over Orlando. Their fans, their team, they're stunned.
Under 548.
Best record in the XFL, 8-2, and they're in trouble.
Undefeated at home during the regular season. Down by 10 here in the fourth.
Fumble.
Still alive.
Frisco's
and
got
San
it.
San Francisco recovers. James Williams. The Demons take control. Nothing has gone right since halftime for Orlando.
Ever since that bad snap. It was that bad snap on the punt.
This is a veteran head coach, Galen Hall.
Come on, guys.
Still surprised that he took out Brian Kuklik, a guy who's got much more experience than this young man, Jim Arianis. handed him the football while Orlando is still very much in this game, down by 3 points. An interception for a touchdown and a fumble, and San Francisco's got it again. I'm shocked.
Eight turnovers tonight at the Citrus Bowl. And here's Barnes and the Demon offense. This is Kelvin Anderson. They're going to grind away now on top by 10 with under 10 minutes left to go. The pick by Dwayne Harper, and then the fumble on the next possession recovered by the veteran James Williams. This is where the veterans have really stepped up for San Francisco.
They was counting us out. We all we got, baby. They was counting us out. We all we got.
There's a bulk up Dennis Rodman.
We're going to do it.
And in stark contrast, young Brian Kuklick. He and the rest of the rage just wondering what's happened.
Round 19. Set it.
Flag, delay a game call.
Coach, you made a quarterback change. You inserted a quarterback that had not played one down. Do you think you made the move too soon now?
No, not at all. Jim's played with me before. I know what he can do, and I don't question that at all.
It's worth noting that Jim Arianez had played under Galen Hall in Europe, and they went to a title game together. But that was Europe, and that was about 15, 16 months ago.
Big difference. A big difference. And again, Brian Kuklick didn't play all that poorly. Had Mario Bailey and Dalio Burks made a couple of catches that they should have made. Could have been a different story.
Play action, and that one passed too far. Well, there was talk coming into the game of the strength of schedule, guys. San Francisco had a tough road to home. They played a schedule tied for the second most difficult in the league. Orlando's was, by our math, the easiest based on the winning percentages of opponents all year long.
Well, the other point is, too, that game, second game of the year meant nothing, and we were right on with that because this is a different San Francisco Demon team that showed up here in Orlando.
You know, Jeff Brom wishes he was in there right now.
Brown 19, Senate.
Third and long now for Barnes and the Demons. Look out. He gets out of the way of a pair of tacklers, but is finally dragged down. Ben Huff there on the sack, and that'll bring on the punting unit.
You know, that was actually a better play rather than throwing an incomplete pass because it keeps the clock running.
Mike Panasek on to punt. Skinny Culver, the return man for Orlando.
Skinny needs to break one here.
There's Culver to start it at his own six. All kinds of flags on the play. Wendell Davis was there to make the tackle, perhaps a bit too early. We'll sort it out when we return. Orlando takes over deep in their own territory, down 10 late.
Let's go, offense!
You know how they get like that? They get like that by eating the meat.
Yeah. Whopper says, carnivores prefer flame broiled. In the land of burgers, the flame broiled Whopper is king.
You have just completed the culminating training event into the United States Army. I want you to think about what it took to get here. This fire represents the soldiers who have completed basic training before you and those who are yet to come. You have what it takes to be a soldier in the greatest army of the world.
Log on and find out what it feels like. Only at GoArmy.com.
Hey, pal, when did you see the light?
I was working away from home. On my own dime, it's crazy to stay anywhere but Motel 6. I could take the extra money and invest it in something. Yeah, like pizza.
Call us and see the light for yourself.
Gatorade Energy Bar. Carve
drugs to build stores of energy. What burns inside you?
Sports drinks! Not cutting it, okay?
What do you bench?
350.
Gallons?
By the way, your body call. Yeah, looking for some vitamin D and A.
Come on!
Hey, I'm on a quarter.
Can I get a spot here?
Yeah. What are you drinking?
Sports drink.
Sports drink. Later, sunshine.
Well, you just hit the stop button. They got a stop button, or you just stop walking, or you got to pile.
Want to play? Milk has 9 essential nutrients active bodies need.
I'm all right. I'm up.
Tonight, Renee Zellweger hosts an all-new Saturday Night Live with musical guest Eve. So what's up at dress rehearsal right now?
What are you looking at?
Sheep. People are sheep.
Maybe I'm just not ready.
Saturday Night Live tonight.
It sounds fabulous.
If you're going to San Francisco, be sure to wear a flower in your hair. And be sure to congratulate the San Francisco Demons on a great comeback so far. The job not finished yet. Plenty of football left. First and 10 for Jim Arianes in the Orlando Rage. Looking to go downfield. That one was almost picked off. Toby Wright was looking for his second one of the night.
I tell you what, if he played for like Galen Hall like that in Europe, he'd have got yanked and never would have been put in the game.
Well, let's go. 060 Y under.
Feared receiving core has not accounted for a whole lot.
I'm telling you guys, they panicked after halfway through that first quarter.
Second and 10 now for young Jim Arianes. Over the middle, he's got a receiver complete to Kevin Swain. Still on his feet. Dwayne Harper runs him out of bounds.
A flag
on the play. A reminder, tomorrow, Chicago and Los Angeles, the hottest team in the XFL to end the season had been the Chicago Enforcers. They're in the Coliseum tomorrow. 7 o'clock Eastern on UPN. That's a rematch of what we think was the best game of the season during regular season play.
81 of the offense.
Oh, man.
The 10-yard penalty be administered from the end of the run.
That's Diallo Burks.
You look at this film, please.
Well, they still get the first down, but they get it with 10 yards more for the touchdown.
Been a frustrating night for Diallo Burks. Among those Rage receivers to drop a couple of balls tonight.
What do you got back here?
Rip, rip! Oh!
So first and 10 from the 28-yard line. Jim Arianes, heads up. Welcome to the XFL. Meet Carl Hansen.
And Orlando's offensive line ranked the best of the league. Consensus among the coaches.
Joe Trey, rocket left on one. Ready?
Been a complete breakdown tonight.
Wow.
Aaron Patrick, the center. Arianes dumps it off, and that one's dropped, and another flag on the play. He was trying to get it out to Michael Black.
What is with the Orlando receivers tonight, Mike? They've dropped over a half a dozen footballs right in their hands.
You know, just talking about Diallo Burks, and here's a guy who was fourth in the XFL in receiving yards.
Holding. Number 79, offense. 10-yard penalty, repeat, second down.
Burks, the best average in the XFL with 19.4 yards a catch. Totally non-existent.
Let's go, zero trade.
Get ready for the turnover here, too, with this quarterback. I can see him trying to force something.
You know, I got a flashback to the first quarter. It was 16-0 Orlando. Terry Battle was taken out of the game for San Francisco. That's their triple threat guy, big part of their offense, and it looked like this was going to be a laugher for the Rage. Arianes can't get out of the way of Carl Hansen once again. Second sack of the series by the Stanford product.
Come on, man.
James Burgess, who has missed the majority of the better part of three quarters, coming back into the game, but I'm afraid this is The emotional tide has already swung in the other direction.
And Mike and Matt, statistics aren't looking good here for Orlando. 0-for-8 on third down conversions tonight. And here they're facing their ninth with third and a mile.
Oh!
Up top, into the corner, Scott.
Oh, he got it.
Is there for it.
Wow!
And they convert on third and 27. First down, Orlando.
We will show you the definition of offensive pass interference.
Well, they're not dead yet. Whether they did it or not, they got away with it.
Well, that's Kloman's here. Okay, I don't have enough for him now. Push your way there. Pretty clever stuff.
It's called creating space.
Yeah, yes. If
you can't do it with speed, you do it with your hands.
First and 10 from the Orlando 45 now. They're going to need a lot more of that here late in the fourth quarter. A wobbler.
Anyone in the face.
Intended for Diallo Burks.
And that is not a happy head coach right there.
Gas it.
One play, 960, 212, wide seam gas on one. Ready?
34 of those 60 yards came on a play just two plays ago. That completion to Scott Kloman. Take that away, and Arianez has really struggled. Look out for Jermaine Miles.
He's got a man open.
Diallo Burks. And he's going to break it. And Orlando is right back in this thing. A 55-yard touchdown play from Arianez to Burks.
They're going for three. They're holding up three fingers. They're going for all of it. Get it!
Silent all night long. Diallo Burks finally breaks the big one.
26 unanswered San Francisco points. And Orlando finally gets
now,
on the board here in the fourth.
Why do you go for three when it's 26-22? Why not go for two and get yourself within a field goal? Or one and you can tie it. I question this. I'll tell you, Coach Hall, he's doing some strange stuff tonight.
This is a three-point PAT attempt from the 10-yard line. Arianez pass.
He got it.
And they convert Mario Bailey. Oh, my goodness. It's a one-point ball game, guys. Ho-ho! Don't uncork the champagne just yet in Florida or California. We'll be right back.
6,000 years ago, a legendary warrior lost a treasure of unlimited power. Now, all the forces of past and present will battle to possess it. The Mummy Returns. Rated PG-13. At theaters Friday, May 4th.
Let's do it.
These guys don't look so tough.
Heads up.
I got your back.
On your left.
Go, go, go.
I'm hot, baby.
Time to go for a spin.
Gatorade. Bring your game to life.
I'll take the big guy.
Which big guy?
The Weekend Warrior. These men don't play for money. They don't play for glory. They play for the love of the game.
No, we don't. We do it for them.
Well, then, if you're trying to impress an XFL cheerleader, I suggest you huddle up with Stacker 2. Stacker 2 is the safe, smart way to burn fat and get an extra boost of energy. Stacker 2, the most valuable fat burner.
Reviewing our last fiscal year, the numbers from January were slightly better than the numbers from February. However, the numbers in January were identical to the numbers in March. The numbers in April were slightly lower than the numbers in March, but identical.
Like playing games? Come to Best Buy, where you can play the latest video games and try out a lot of other cool stuff. Best Buy. Go ahead, turn on the fun.
Don't bend over to pick up any change you might have dropped in the couch tonight.
Yeah.
Now a one-point ball game. Brian Roberson to return the kickoff. And the crowd is right back in this ball game as a result of this touchdown pass to Diallo Burke. No player in the XFL has more big play potential than Diallo Burks. He may have been setting that up all night long, and a great throw by Jimmy Arianis.
He set it up by dropping four of them.
He got behind Kevin Casebehart and then was off to the races. And here's the three-point after drive from the 10-yard line. The pass complete to Mario Bailey. It's a nine-point scoring sequence for Orlando. On the ground for Kelvin Anderson. And now it's a keyed-up defense, and James Burgess is back in there. He got in on that tackle.
And remember, Orlando has all three timeouts, so they can stop the clock at will.
The man whose motor's always running, and he's giving them the emotional lift they needed after that nine-point swing. Unbelievable. He was knocked out in the first quarter. He has come back with his Orlando Rage down by just a point. Just over 2 minutes left to determine who goes to the million-dollar championship game.
Well, they're throwing this one. There's no running backs.
That's Jimmy the Jet Cunningham, another guy who's come back after injury.
Play.
And a first down for San Francisco.
David! Dana! Dana!
That gentleman was a huge play right there,
on,
facing
Dana,
second and 10.
San Francisco had to move the chains at least once.
We got
to
eat it all the way up, you know what I mean?
They're taking it to the two-minute warning right now.
It's all right. We get one more first down.
Jim Skipper well aware of the timeout situation.
Now, Mike, why wouldn't you use a timeout before the two-minute warning, and then you get it again?
Doesn't matter.
No, it's a two-minute warning.
Two-minute warning, time on the field.
All right, here we go. Here we go.
Pain, king, sacrifice, risk. All for a shot at $1 million.
The best team in the XFL, guys.
They won four straight.
I don't think nobody's going to stop us right now.
One team stands between them and the million-dollar game.
Division champs, baby!
The Western Division champion Extreme continue to light up the scoreboard and have million-dollar dreams of their own. The Enforcers, the Extreme, the XFL Playoffs, Sunday on UPN.
The Enforcers and the Extreme among those watching tonight to find out who will be the first team to earn a shot at the million-dollar championship game. It's San Francisco on top by just a point, 2 minutes left. Barnes wants a block and wisely slides to the ground.
And wisely stays in bounds. Make him use the timeout.
Orlando has two of them left.
Orlando better be careful here, too. They're bringing about nine men up in the box, Mike, and they could get burned on a pass right here. They're assuming, of course, as everyone is, that San Francisco is going to run the ball every play.
And Pat Barnes, the kind of quarterback not afraid to take a gamble. This game has seen eight turnovers.
Coach, I need to play.
Okay, here we go.
I'm going out there.
I don't know.
The timeouts inside of 2 minutes are only of the 30-second variety. And Barnes didn't really have a good chance to consult his coordinator there on the sidelines.
3-0 left. Okay, give me 6 oceans.
3-0 left, 6 oceans. On one, ready?
Go! 319!
second and 10.
19.
The hand to Calvin Anderson. Drop for no gain. James Roberson was there on the tackle, as was Mark Campbell.
Another Orlando timeout.
And they're down to one on a third down.
An interception on his first play.
No huddle. Get up. Watch, no huddle. What?
Galen Hall hoping to get another offensive series.
They got one timeout left. How many timeouts they got? One? They got one?
They got one, Jim.
Yep.
Good stuff.
Could anyone have envisioned this scenario after it was 16-0?
Oh, look at this. Out of the shotgun. They're going to put it in the air.
Third and 11. No backs. Barnes, look out.
He's got control.
He's got it.
A huge first down for San Francisco.
And that may have won the ball game for him.
A 31-yard pass play.
That's you. Baby.
Yeah. That one's for you, Mom. That one's for you, Mom.
Pat Barnes never had any doubts. You know that? Never had any doubts.
Yeah, last week Pat's mom was bawling him out for yelling at a referee after a pass interference call. I'd love to see her in her living room right now.
Guys, that was $1 million third down play, maybe.
Pat Barnes' mom is turning the furniture upside down in the house right now. She's so happy.
Smackdown in her own home.
Calvin Anderson. It's academic, maybe a gain of a yard, and Orlando burns their final timeout.
Last one, right?
They've got to try to strip the ball loose now because you know they're not going to put it in the air.
70 seconds.
It all came down to that one play and the gamble, the big third down play. San Francisco electing to go no backfield out of the shotgun formation. Barnes patiently waiting for Cunningham to get open, and the Jet did his job and held out of the football.
He had Corey Gilliard coming up in his face, and he still got it away. Jimmy, the Jet's a guy that might have to have surgery on his elbow after that ligament problem earlier. He's back in there tonight, and we don't say we're sure about
surgery. He don't need no surgery.
But, you know, he was hurt a moment ago and had to come out of the game. He just makes the biggest play of his life.
Matt, you're exactly right. Had this been week five of the game, you know, not a playoff variety, Jimmy Cunningham would not be back in this football game.
Who was going to get it, boy?
Skip's starting to feel good. Starting to feel the playoff love. Oh my, they were down 16-0 to start the game 6 minutes into the first quarter. San Francisco had never come back from a deficit of greater than 6 points all year long.
Coach, obviously this one's a foregone conclusion. Did you ever think you'd get this result the way this thing started?
Well, we always have confidence. Like we tell our guys, keep our composure. It's not over till it's over. It's not in till it's in. All right? And the game can start any kind of way. Either they get a big jump going or we get one going and it's not over. There's a lot of football left and we've persevered all year and it's a tribute to our guys.
Let me ask you this. Do you happen to make a decision on a starting quarterback next week?
Well, hey, we'll deal with that when it's time. Gosh.
A little rough stuff there after the whistle. Well, Pat Barnes doesn't care.
Well, he didn't go down. He never took the knee. He just started backing up, and Orlando just kind of stood around for a while, but that's the ball game.
They were 6.5-point underdogs. They trailed 16-0 in the first quarter. They were coming off an absolute blowout. Last week they got smoked in Los Angeles, shut out. And on the road, San Francisco has beaten previous previously home undefeated Orlando.
And that man, the difference tonight, Pat Barnes and that gutsy third down call.
My goodness. An enormous upset, maybe the biggest of the season. The San Francisco Demons are playing in the $1 million championship game.
Probably one of the biggest star-sam finishes in your career. Can you talk about tonight's game? Didn't look good early on.
No, it didn't. You know, we had a lot of adversity. We fought through it. I think our team has had a lot of character all year, and it showed through.
Chicago struck early, but LA came roaring back.